Here we'll be starting lesson number 6, cash flow statement. Okay, in this particular chapter, please omit point number 6 and point number 8. Okay, omitted illustrations 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 14, 15 and 16, and omitted in exercise the questions which you have to omit, that is 15, 16, 17, 20 and 21. Fine. Rest of the points we are discussing, see first, that is introduction. Okay, see here in cash flow statement, what you have to understand, that what is your inflow and outflow. Okay, you have to understand this only, that is when cash is coming in the business, it is your inflow, and when cash is going outside the business, it is outflow. So in cash flow statement, you have to see that what is coming in the business and what is going outside the business, and at the end what is left out. Clear? So see, first introduction. Profit and loss statement and balance sheet are included in financial statement. This you have already studied, that in financial statement what is been there. So profit and loss and balance sheet. Next, this you keep in mind, that these statements are prepared on mercantile base. Okay, for objective question, understand that on which basis this profit and loss statement and balance sheet is prepared. It is prepared on the mercantile base. Fine. Next, and what is mercantile base, that you have studied in 11th and 11th standard in accountancy. Okay. Now, where actual expense and actual income of respective year, whether paid in cash or not, whether recorded, received in cash or not, are recorded. See, mercantile base is this only, that whether cash is paid or not, or you have received or not, you have to record the entries. Okay, this concept you have studied in 11th standard in mercantile base. Okay, that is accounting based on mercantile basis and Deshinama and all other. Okay, so here in mercantile base, what you have to remember, whether you have paid or not, or whether you have received or not, you have to record the expenses, where actual expenses, okay, in mercantile base, actual expenses and actual income of the respective year, whether it is paid or not, received or not, you have to record that things in P&L statement. Okay, that is coming under mercantile base. Now next is, that is revenue expense and revenue incomes are disclosed in profit and loss statement. Equity and liability, that is all, leave it. Okay, next, what you'll remember in brief, profit and loss which is prepared on mercantile base show profitability of the business. Balance sheet provide the information about economic solvency. So when you're preparing the statement on the basis of mercantile base, you get the exact knowledge of your profitability of the business, and you get exact knowledge of your balance sheet, that will be giving you the information regarding your solvency, that is economic solvency, that is financial. Okay, you are financially solvent or not. Fine. Next is, that is, come here. As per accounting standard 3, disclosure of cash flow statement is mandatory from 1/4/2004 on and onwards for certain business enterprise. Okay, so for certain businesses, okay, it is very much compulsory, that is mandatory. Mandatory means it is compulsory according to accounting standard 3 disclosure, that cash flow statement is compulsory to be prepared from 1/4/2004 and onwards for certain businesses. Okay, the disclosure of cash flow statement is mandatory for those business units whose equity or debt securities are listed in the process. See, here they have said that for certain business units. So for which business unit it is compulsory? So the units which are giving the equity and debt securities which are listed in the list, okay, according to Indian Foreign Stock Exchange. Okay, so whichever company's equity and debts, that is liability, debentures, okay, are listed in the stock exchange, that all business units have to prepare cash flow statement, which is compulsory for them to be prepared, that is since 1/4/2004. As per accounting standard 3, these business enterprises have to prepare the cash flow statement under indirect method. Okay, under which method they have to prepare? So they have to prepare under the indirect method. Fine. Further, see, under section 2/40 of Companies Act 2013, the cash flow statement is included in the definition of financial statement. Clear? So the definition of cash flow statement is there, which is given in the financial statement. Now second topic is meaning of terminologies. There are few terminologies which we need to understand. See, first is cash flow. There are two types of cash flow. One is inflow and one is outflow, which I explained you here also, that there are two types of cash flow. Okay. So there are two types of cash flow, one is cash inflow and one is cash outflow. Your cash flow means See, cash flow means receipt and payment of cash and cash equivalent. Okay, simply what do you mean by cash flow? Okay, so this is the meaning of simply of cash flow. Okay, cash flow means receipt and payment of cash and cash equivalent. A transaction due to which cash or cash equivalent increases. See, when cash increases, it is known as cash inflow. It means it is coming to you. When the cash decreases, it is known as cash outflow. So here are three different things they have explained in this one paragraph. That is, one is cash flow. It means receipt and payment of cash or cash equivalent. One is cash inflow. When in cash increases, it is inflow. When cash decreases, it is cash outflow. Okay. See, they have shown you here cash inflow, cash outflow. So that is, for example, your cash inflow is 1 lakh and your outflow is, that is 85,000. Okay, so the remaining amount is a positive amount. That's why it is known as net cash inflow. In the next example, they have showed that cash inflow is 85, whereas cash outflow is 1 lakh. So the net is coming in negative, so that's why it has been kept in the bracket. And thus, it is known as net cash outflow. So when you are getting the amount in bracket at the end, it means it is showing you the outflow. When you are getting a positive amount, it is showing you the net cash inflow. Okay, now what do you mean by cash? Cash means cash on hand or the bank balance which is there in the bank. That is known as cash. Next is, what do you mean by cash equivalent? Cash equivalent means highly liquid short-term investment. Any investment which you can easily convert into cash, that is known as cash equivalent. Such investment which can be quickly and with accurate estimated price convertible into cash. That is, exactly you know that you will get this much amount when you convert it into cash. Okay, and easily you can convert that investment into cash. The investment in which the risk of changes in the price is very rare. So such type of investment where there are very rarely the price are changing, okay, that is government securities or any securities having above stated features. So any type of investment which you can easily convert into cash is known as cash equivalent. Might be some shares or gold or any other currency, foreign currency, that which you can easily convert. So that is just similar to cash equivalent. Next is cash flow statement. Okay, three type of activities are disclosed in the cash flow statement. You are going to learn this three in a theoretical portion. Okay, so how many types of activities are there in cash flow statement? So there are three types of activities. See, I'm not asking types of cash flow. Types of cash flow are two: cash inflow and cash outflow. Here I'm asking, that is, which type of activities are there in cash flow statement? Okay, so there are three types of activities in cash flow statement. One is operating activity, one is investing activity, and one is financing activity. Fine. There can be cash inflow or outflow in each activity. In all these three activities, there will be inflow and outflow. The opening balance of cash and cash equivalent is added to cash flow generated through these three activities. At the end of whatever amount would arrive will be closing balance of cash. When you are calculating for all these three, at the end, whatever you are getting, that will be considered as your closing cash balance. Cash flow generated from these activities can be positive or negative, as I showed here. Okay, it can be positive, it can be negative. If it is positive, it is known as net cash inflow. If it is negative, then it will be known as net cash outflow. Clear? Just turn the page. This is not important for us. Okay. Now see, I'll just inform you that here you are going to study about three activities: operating activity, investing activity, and financial activity. Theory portion you have to learn for all three, but practical sums we are only supposed to do for investing activities. There are practical sums for operating and financing, but according to your reduced syllabus, 30% by government, okay, instructions, according to government board instructions, you have to do the sums which are based on only investing activities. So hardly 5 sums are there which you have to do for this particular chapter. Okay, theory you will learn for all three, but practical sums you will be only doing for investing activities. Fine. Now see, our next activity we are going to start, that is operating activity. Fine. Now first of all, what do you mean by operating activity? Suppose it is asked, what is operating activity? So you have to write down this much, okay, that what is there in operating activity. See, this is the definition of operating activity. Fine. Operating activity means main activities of business to earn income, which are neither investing nor financing. Okay, so this is the definition for operating. That is, operating activities means main activities of business to earn income, which is neither investing activity nor financing activity. Fine. So if in one mark it is asked what is operating activities, you will write down this much. See, or what they have written, operating activities are activities that emerge from profit and loss statement. Transactions recorded in profit and loss statement are classified for these activities. Okay, in this context, operating expenses related discussion is done in the previous chapter. Okay, leave it. Only remember this, that operating activities means main activities of the business to earn income, which is neither investing activities nor financing activities. Okay, these are those activities on the basis of which main income of business is created. The identification of operating activity is determined on the basis of nature of industry of a business unit. The identification of operating activity of each business is based on the nature of business. See, now this three is important for theoretical portion. Okay, that is trading company. For this kind of company, activities of purchase, sales of goods are main activities of the income generation. Okay, for trading company, which is their main activity, purchase and sale of goods. So that will be coming under operating activity for a trading company. Next is for insurance company. For insurance company, premium received and payment of claim. Okay, the amount of premium will be income for the insurance company, and the payment of claims will be the expenses. So these activities, the main activity for insurance company. Fine. Bank, so lending of loan and acceptance of deposit. Okay, so this work is important for the bank. So for trading, purchase and sale. For insurance, the amount of premium collected and the claim amount paid. Here, lending the money as a loan and accepting the money as a deposit. So these are the activities which are important for trading company, insurance company and bank. Fine. Generally, by dividing forms of company into two categories, clarity can be obtained: non-finance company and financing company. See, here they have mentioned, okay, that is cash flow from operating activities. Non-financing companies are income and receipt from sale of goods and services, income and receipt from commission or royalty, any other income which is not arise from investment activity. So it is there given in the definition, main activity, rather than neither financing nor that is operating. Fine. Sorry, financing and investing. Okay, so here you can also remember any other income which is not arise from investing or finance. Collection from debtors and bills receivable. Payment for purchase of goods and services. Payment to creditors and for bills payable. Salary, wages or any amount paid to employees, for example bonus. Sales and distribution expense. Receipt of income tax refund or payment of tax other than investing and financing. Okay, so these are all for non-finance companies. Now next is for finance companies. Purchase of security, interest paid on deposit, sale of security, interest received on lended loan, salary or amount paid to employees, receipt of income tax refund or payment of tax or other than investing and financing activity. See, if you were supposed to do the sums based on operating activities, then to remember all this was very important. Okay, right now you just remember that operating activities are classified again on the basis of non-finance company and finance company. Clear? So this much you will remember for operating activity. Okay, that is whatever are the main activities for you in the business rather than investing and financing is known as operating. Here they have given trading will be having purchase and sales. Insurance company will be having premium of amount to be received and payment of claims, and bank, that is lending amount as a loan and acceptance of a deposit. Okay, these three are coming under operating activity under the category of main activities. Okay. See, now second activity is investing activities. Okay, this theory also you have to remember, plus practical sums also you have to do on the basis of this activity. Fine. Investing activity arise from transaction of asset side of balance sheet. See, simply remember here you are only supposed to see the assets. Okay, investing activities means purchase and sale of long-term investments or other investments. So here you are supposed to deal only in purchase and sale of assets or amount which you are receiving on the basis of such kind of assets. For example, interest received on investment or like that. Okay, dividend received on investment, such kind of things. Next, see, cash and cash equivalent are not included. Your cash and cash equivalent are not included. Long-term assets are those assets which are not acquired for the sale purpose. They are used for the business activity. For example, purchase of such asset is treated as cash outflow. Okay, when you are purchasing any kind of asset, it will be treated as cash outflow. See, because when you are purchasing, you are paying the cash. So cash is going outside. Same way, sale is treated as cash inflow. When you are selling any asset, the cash is coming into your business. Okay, so you are supposed to remember only these two things. That is, when you will purchase asset, cash will go, that is outflow. And when you are selling anything, on sale of asset, you are receiving the goods, you are receiving the cash, so it will be treated as cash inflow. Fine. For example, land and building, machinery, furniture, and other assets held for the generation of income are also included in investment activity. The income received due to investment, like interest or dividend received, okay, so that will be also considered as, or rent received, this will be also considered as investing activity. Okay, so in investment, what you'll remember, assets, when you're purchasing asset, cash is going, so it will be outflow. Fine. When you're selling asset, on sale of asset, you're receiving the cash, so here there will be inflow. When you are receiving interest or dividend, this also will be your, that is inflow, okay, cash inflow. When you are receiving interest or dividend or rent, okay, for investing activities, so here it will be treated as cash inflow. Next, remember this table, cash inflow and outflow, when the inflow will be there and when there will be outflow. Sale of fixed tangible asset, tangible which you are able to see, that is land and building, okay, any type of that, machinery, vehicle. So when you are selling, it is inflow. When you are selling any intangible asset, that is also cash inflow. For example, goodwill, patent, copyright, trademark. Sale of long-term investment, okay, any type of investment, for example, share, debenture or bonds. Or return of long-term lending, you have given to someone for 5 years and now the person is paying you back after 5 years, okay, so that is also an income for you. It will be coming under cash inflow. When it will be treated as outflow, so when you're purchasing the fixed tangible asset, purchase of intangible asset, self-constructed asset, okay, you have constructed that asset for your own consumption, that is self-construction. And remember, this is also coming as an section B in question answers, okay, that is answer in one sentence, that self-constructed assets are coming under which category. So it is coming under investment activities, under cash outflow. Remember like this, again I'm repeating, self-constructed assets are coming under which activity. So it is coming under investing activities, under outflow, okay, that is cash outflow. Then purchase of long-term investment, share, like shares, debentures, when you're purchasing all this, okay, and long-term lending, you are lending someone, okay, to your friend or someone for 5 years or 3 years or 2 years, then it is treated as cash outflow, okay. So these are the activities, that is inflow and outflow, which are coming under the investing activities, okay. We will be doing sums on this activity. Next is, that is financing activity, okay. One was operating, one is financing, and one is investing, okay, that we have seen here. Now in financing, see, here in investment you are only concerned about assets, so here in financing you are only concerned about liabilities, okay, remember this. In financing activities you are only concerned about the liabilities. See, financing activities arise from the transaction of equity and liability, okay, except those of current liability. See, you are not supposed to consider the current liabilities, please remember this, okay. And off balance sheet, financing activities are such activities due to which size and composition of owner's capital, that is preference share capital, equity share capital, borrowed capital, will get changed, okay. Financing activities have relation, see, here you are not supposed to take current liabilities, you are only supposed to concern with non-current liabilities and shareholder fund, okay. You have studied non-current liabilities, okay, you have studied company's final account, that is your equity and liability is divided into three part. First is shareholder fund, non-current liability, and the third is current liability. Current liability you are not supposed to take into consideration in financing activities, okay. Financing activities have relation with increase or decrease of equity share capital, preference share capital, debentures or loans. It means that the increase in long-term owner capital and borrowed capital, that will be showing you cash inflow, and reduction shows you. See, when your long-term owner capital and borrowed capital is increasing, that is cash inflow. When it is decreasing, it is cash outflow. See, here they have shown. issue if equity share. If you have issued equity shares in the market, then public will pay for that. As public are paying, the company is receiving, so it is known as inflow. Same way for preference share also it is inflow. Issue of debentures also, when you're issuing the debentures in the market, people are paying you the money. So that will be inflow for the company. Procurement, if you're taking any loan or long-term liability or increase in bank overdraft. So all this is inflow. Okay, bank overdraft is increased, it means bank is giving you. Okay, so that is again cash inflow. Outflow, so buyback of equity shares. You are buying your own equity shares from the market. You are redeeming. Redemption means repay. Okay, that we have studied in debentures. So redeem means repay. When you are repaying back, see here you are paying back. Okay, so cash is going. So it is outflow. Redemption of debenture, redemption of loan, dividend payment, okay, reduction in bank overdraft or interest paid on debts. So that is all an outflow for you. Again, this is only for theoretical purpose. You are not supposed to do any sums on this method, that is financing activity. Okay. Next, you are going to study in theoretical portion, that is special activities. Okay. Which things are coming under special activities, that we will see. Now, see in special activities, that is two activities from one transaction. Transaction is only one, but two activities are taking place out of that. See now. Two type of payments are included in each installment of higher purchase. Payment towards principal amount and interest. Suppose you are purchasing AC on EMI. Okay, you have to pay the principal amount also, plus you have to pay the interest also. For example, the AC cost is 52,000. Now this you have purchased on EMI. Okay, that is in installments you are going to pay. So now this 52,000 will be costing you with with interest, that is 60,000. Okay, cost price is this, but with interest now you have to pay 60,000. Clear? So that 8,000 you have to pay extra. Okay, that is here this will be considered as principal amount, and here the 8,000 difference is considered as interest. So see, when you are paying principal amount, payment towards principal, it is an investing activity because you are purchasing an asset. Okay, so investment activity of cash outflow because you are purchasing an asset, so it is cash outflow. But when you are paying the interest for this, it is return of liability, that is a financing activity of cash outflow. So when you are paying interest, it will be coming under, that is financing activity. And when you are purchasing and your payment, you are doing the payment for that principal amount, so you are doing an investing activity because you are purchasing an asset. Is this clear? So your one activity is there, but one transaction is there, but two activities are taking place. So it is treated as two activities from one transaction. Clear? Next, second number, cash transaction but no cash inflow or outflow. See, cash deposited with bank. You have deposited the cash in bank. So cash is reduced, bank balance is increased. But see, cash is going into your own bank account, not in somebody else's bank account. Okay? You are depositing your cash in your bank account. So cash is not going anywhere from you. Okay? It is just simply from your hand, the cash is going to your bank account. So thus, it is not affecting any transaction. Same way, cash withdrawn from bank. You are taking money from your own account. Okay? So here, though cash is increased, but the bank balance will be reduced, but it is your own bank balance. So cash balance and bank balance are shown at the same time in cash flow statement. It is known as cash and cash equivalent. This transaction has no relation with cash, but does not influence, it is having relation with cash, but it does not influence cash and cash equivalent. See, though the cash is affected, but it is not going or coming from the business. It is simply going from your cash on hand, that is from shop to your bank account, or from bank account it is coming to your shop. Okay, so this transaction is also, though it is a cash transaction, but there will be no effect on cash inflow or outflow. Right? Third, that is non-cash transactions and provisions. Now see, in this third, many transactions of business are not done in cash form. Thus, during preparation of cash flow, these transactions are not considered as cash flow. For example, depreciation. Depreciation is a non-cash expense. See, you are not paying this to someone. Okay? You are simply keeping aside. That is, the depreciation amount is kept aside. You are not paying to someone. That's why cash is not going outside the business. Same way, amount amortized, that is, return off. might be the return off on any intangible asset, okay, patent or goodwill. So this also you are just keeping aside, you are not going to pay to someone. Issue of equity share and debenture without cash consideration. You are giving equity share and debentures to someone, but cash is not coming. Same way, conversion of debenture into equity. Debentures are converted into equity shares. Okay, so here also cash is not coming to you. Okay, so here there are some special transactions which are treated as non-cash transaction. Okay, so though you are keeping the amount aside, but for that you are not actually receiving or paying it to someone. Thus, it is treated as non-cash transactions and provisions. Okay, so these three type of transactions are treated as special activities. Clear? So see, this much you have to remember for theoretical purpose. Okay, now in the next video we will be seeing how to do these sums, which are based on investing activities. Okay, sums are only for investing activities, that we will be seeing in the next video.